Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of John. The Gospel of John is my favorite, and so is St. Thomas, Gnostic Gospel of St. Thomas. So they are quite spiritual, but Gospel of St. Thomas is more accurate in narration than this Gospel of John, which has been altered by the people. But the Gospel of St. Thomas has not had the opportunity for these people to alter. And so here it goes. Exposition of John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So that means His Word and God, the essence of the God is His Word. The nature of God is described in His Word. The same was in the beginning with God. That means in the beginning, it was with the God in the beginning. And all things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. Now, the God does not make things. The maker of the things which we see with the two naked eyes is Yahweh, the creator of male and female. That is the flesh. But what is inside us, the soul, is of God. And that is the dominant, that's the real self. Whereas the flesh and what is of Yahweh is mythological or unreal. That means without soul, the flesh is useless. So the reality or the real self of the person is its soul. In Him was life. As I said, you know, the life is soul, and the life was the light of men. So inside us, in our soul, is the embedded the light of God, was the light of men. Light of men means the spirit of men, common sense, or what people, common people, will know about each other. And the light shineth in darkness. So where there is a religious darkness, this light of God shines there, and the darkness comprehended it not. The darkness means the people who are spiritually sick or who are blind to spirit could not comprehend it, because they were not blessed with the grace of God. Unless you have the grace of God, you cannot comprehend the light of God. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. So there was a man sent from God, that he was a prophet, Elijah, whose name was John. John was of the Levite tribe, and people of Levite tribe were doing the work of the Kohen in temples. So his father, John's father, who was of Levite tribe, was doing the job of a Kohen in the temple. His name was Zechariah. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. So John the Baptist was a witness to the light, but not the light. He was a, if we have a light of God equivalent, or suppose we make it equal to the sun, as sun is the primary source of light, so is our Father God the primary source of light. So if we equate God to sun, then John the Baptist was moon. So moon is a reflecting, is the reflection of the light of sun. So moon is the our physical body is the moon, whereas what is inside us, which is soul and through which we preach gospel, and that is of sun. So the rabbis, they teach the moral laws. So moral laws apply to physical bodies. So the rabbis, they are witness to the God, but not the light of God. They have the light of God, but they were not telling or giving it to the people in general, but only to the sensible people, grown-up people, and that light was called oral Torah. Now, John the Baptist, he came as a witness to the light and not the light. And he was an ideal moral teacher. And he had the full knowledge of the scriptures, because he had a knowledge of the oral Torah. The knowledge of the oral Torah come to you if you do not love mammon. If you love mammon, you then hate God, as the temple priests were doing. So John the Baptist, he was not loving mammon at all. He lived in wilderness, and his food was honey and locust, and he has a tunic of a camel's skin. So his dependence on mammon was zero. So he had the full light of God shining in his heart. So he had the full knowledge of Torah. He was not the light. So John the Baptist did not belong to the field of the sun. So he was not the light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. So he was sent to bear witness to of that light, which was Christ Jesus. So Christ Jesus came in the field of sun, whereas John the Baptist came in the field of moon. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. Now John is telling the light which Christ Jesus had, that was the true light, and which is we call absolute truth, gospel truth, which lighteth every man, which lighteth the heart of every man, and that cometh into the world. So whosoever cometh into the world, but unless you are have the grace of God, you cannot apprehend this light. So I will come to that, how Peter was once born, and he stayed once born throughout until Pentecost, because he had not the grace of God. He was in the Word, and the Word was made by him, and the Word knew him not. He was in the Word, Christ Jesus was in the Word. Remember that Christ Jesus had Father, which is God, and he had all the powers of the God. But he was Son of God, he was God-like, but not God himself. So he cannot, as Christ Jesus said himself, a worker can be trained to the standard of the master, but he cannot be the master. So Christ Jesus had all the powers which God has, but he was not equal to God. But he was equal to God, but he was not greater than God. God was the omni, all in all. And the Word was made by him. That means all the creation that we see, the soul in the everyone, is of God. And the Word knew him not. The Word did not knew him, because unless you have the grace of God, you cannot have the knowledge of the light of God. Thank you.